Start.
Good morning. My name is G. Lakshmi Priyanka, Assistant Professor, St. Martin's Engineering College, Dolapalli. So today I am going to tell you about signals and systems classification. So in this video, I will cover classification of signals. So before going into the classification of signal, so let me explain what is meant by a signal. So a signal is a physical quantity. So, which varies with respect to one or more independent variables. So, signals are of two types available in our nature, that is analog and digital. So, this analog, digital. So, this analog form is also called as continuous waveform. Okay. So, this analog can also be called as continuous waveform. While digital is called as a digital signal. So this analog signal can be converted into a digital signal by following two procedures. So before going into the analog to digital, between a signal is there, that is called discrete signal. So any signal should be converted into a discrete signal by using a processor called sampling. So after obtaining a discrete signal, you can convert it into a digital signal by following a processor called quantization. So that is up to the signal. So what is meant by signal and what are the available two types of signals I told you. So apart from these two, we have the classification of signals. So classification of signals means, as already I told you, there are two types of signals, that is analog and digital. So in our subject signals and systems, we are mainly concentrating on analog part and discrete part. So any analog signal can be represented with x of t function, and any discrete signal will be represented with x of n. Okay, here t, why I am writing as x of t means that this is varying with respect to time. And here why I am writing x of n means this is varying with respect to n. N means number of samples. T means time period. So coming to the classification of signals. So classification of signals, how many signals are there? Means there are six types of signals. First one is continuous, time and discrete time signal. Continuous time signal and discrete time signal. And next one is deterministic, and the next fifth one is periodic and aperiodic signal, and the last one is energy and power signal. Okay, so these are very very important classification of signals, these six types. So continuous time signal, already I told you, it is also called as analog signal. Means whatever signal you are taking, it will be varying continuously with respect to time. On x axis you will take t, on y axis you will represent the function x of t. While coming to discrete time signal you can only represent in the format of samples. That's why on x axis I will take n and y axis I will take x of n. So in the format of definition, if you wanted to say, you have to say, this continuous time signal will vary with respect to time. With every instant of time, the amplitude of the signal will vary. But while coming to the discrete type of signal, the amplitude of a signal, at particular instant of time only you can justify or you can indicate. So, at only particular instant of time, you can represent its amplitude. That's why it is named as discrete. Discrete means distinct or particular time. Okay, while coming to deterministic and random signal. So any signal, if you are able to determine mathematically or by using a mathematical equation, it is called deterministic signal. And any signal, if you are not able to represent it mathematically, it is called random So example of this deterministic is, you can say like x of t is equal to 3 sin t. Here you can represent it in terms of a trigonometric equation, that is mathematical format. And random signal example, you can say noise. A noise signal cannot be determined mathematically. Coming to the third one, casual and non-casual. So casual signal, non-casual signal. So any signal, so if you are able to represent only on the right side, that means if you are representing only on the x of t when t is greater than 0, then you can say that signal is casual. So if you are not able to represent when t greater than 0, only if you are able to represent when t less than 0, then that is called non-casual signal. So coming to the next other type of signal, the signal is even and odd signal. So even and odd signal means, so even and odd signal has one mathematical representation, that is, so this fourth type even signal, so whenever you are able to prove that x of t is equal to x of minus t, or if you are taking a discrete type signal, then if you are able to prove x of n is equal to x of minus n, so then you can say this particular signal is an even signal. And there is another type of signal called odd signal. So when you are able to prove that minus of x of minus t, or when you are considering the discrete signal, when you are able to prove minus x of minus n, then this indicates that it is an odd signal. Okay, so next is the periodic and aperiodic signal. So periodic signal means what? Any signal which repeats at regular interval of time, that signal is called periodic signal. So periodic signal, if we are not able to repeat at regular interval of time, that is called a periodic signal. So a periodic signal, if you wanted to represent it mathematically, so x of t should be equal to x of t plus t naught. Here t naught indicates time period. So if you wanted to write the equation for a periodic, then what happens? X of t will not be equal to x of t plus t naught. That is related to periodic and aperiodic. So coming to energy and power signal. So energy and power signal, so these are having different equations to represent. But coming to what is meant by energy signal means, so energy signal will be having energy, some finite value. Okay, energy will be having some finite value. So if you come into any signal, so if you are taking a signal like this, so the part of energy consisted by that signal, the part of amount of the matter consisting by that signal is determined as energy of the signal. And the highest amplitude or highest energy of the particular signal is called as power of the signal. So here this energy signal, so this particular signal, if you observe, the amount of matter consisting in the signal is generally indicated as energy of the signal. And whatever the amplitude, this highest part is there, that is indicated in power of the signal. And coming to this, the general equation, the general statement is, so whenever for a signal, if you are getting energy value finite and power value zero, then it is called as an energy signal. And at the same time, if you are getting energy value infinity and power value some finite value, then it will be called as some power signal. Okay, these are the different types of classification of signals. Generally, in nature, we will be having two signals, that is analog and digital. And in our subject, we will use analog signal and discrete signal. So in order to convert analog into discrete, we will be using sampling. And classification of signals, how many are there? Continuous and discrete, deterministic and random, casual and non-casual, even and odd, and periodic, aperiodic, energy and power signal. These are the classification of signals. Now, let me explain about classification of systems. Okay, so system. Before going into the classification of systems, let us learn what is meant by a system. Okay, so system means what? So system means, it is a device which will be having one input and which will be having output. Okay, so a device which is having input, and regarding its functionality, if it process and if it generate the output, that is called as a system. So in our classification of systems, in the signals and systems subject, we are having at most 7 classification of systems. So first one is, as usual, here also you will have continuous time system and discrete time system. Continuous time system. by the discrete time signal. Same parallelly, the output will be for continuous time system, output will be continuous time signal, and for discrete time system, the output will be discrete time signal. So that is the thing. And coming to the next type of system, the system is casual system and non-casual system, and next static, dynamic. So this casual system, non-casual system, static, dynamic, linear and non-linear.
Thank you.